Welcome, coders! We'll be releasing videos every month that show you fun ways to get hands-on with code. Let's get started! Microbits can do just about anything, even monitor the environment. Today, we're going to show you how to create your own microbit weather station using everyday objects that you can find at the dollar store. We're going to use our microbits to measure wind force and water levels. Here's what you'll need. 2 microbits. 2 battery packs. 2 USB wires. 1 computer. 1 large popsicle stick. 2 more large popsicle sticks with 1 rounded end cut off and a small 0.5-inch hole drilled in the rounded end. 2 round wooden sticks or dowels, one cut to 8 inches length, the other to 6 inches. A 7-inch by 5.5-inch rectangle of craft board. A rectangular piece of wood, 1 inch by 4 inch, cut to 8 inches long. 1 styrofoam ball, approximately 2 inch in diameter. 2 bottle caps. 1 pair of safety scissors. Masking tape and duct tape. 1 glue gun. Before we start coding, make sure your microbit is updated and paired with your computer. This will make it easier to transfer your project to the microbit. Click the link in the top right corner if you need help with this step. Let's head over to the MakeCode website to start putting our code together. Start by clicking the New Project button. Okay, let's get coding the first microbit entered it into wind force sensor. Open the radio category and drag out the radio set group block. Nest it in the onStart block like this. We're going to change the number in the white circle to 5. Now let's go to the LED category. Click More and drag out Set Brightness. Place it beneath the radio set group block and change the number to 25. This will help us save energy and make the most of our microbit's battery life. Next, open the Basic category and drag out Show LEDs. Place it beneath the Set Brightness block. Add one dot in the middle of the grid. Next, we'll add some code to constantly monitor the pitch of this microbit and use the radio function to send the data to microbit 2. Open the variable category and make a new variable called pitch, nested in the forever block. Next, open the input category and click on more. Drag the rotation pitch button and nest it within the set pitch 2 block so it replaces the 0, like this. Lastly, go to the radio category and select the radio send value block. Place it beneath the set pitch to block. Now, go back to the variables category and nest the pitch block in the radio send value block. Now you can download your project to your microbit. Name it microbit 1 and check if you see the dot on the microbit. See the dot? Congrats! Unplug your microbit and attach your battery pack. Now it's time to code the second microbit and turn it into a wind force monitor. Open up a new project in another tab of your browser. Start by deleting the forever block by dragging it over to the category menu on the left. Open the radio category and drag out radio set group. Nest it in the unstart block and change the number to 5. Now let's open the LED category. Click more and drag out set brightness. Place it beneath the radio set group block and set the number to 10. Next, open the basic category and select the show icon block. Place it beneath the set brightness block. Let's start another piece of code. Open the radio category and drag out on radio received name value. This will listen to the data being sent from the first microbit. Next, click the advanced button in the category menu and open the serial category. Drag out serial write value and place it beneath the radio received name value block. Drag the name block on top of the X to replace it. Do the same thing with the value block to replace the 0. Download the project to your microbit and leave it plugged in so it can receive data from the weather station. Now that we're done coding, let's do a little bit of DIY arts and crafts. First, glue the flat ends of your large popsicle sticks to either end of your wooden base. The end with the hole should be at the top. Once the glue has set, insert the longer dowel through the two holes. Glue a bottle cap over each end. Get your craft board. Attach one of the long ends to the dowel using duct tape. We're going to continue this project with a microbit weather station we made earlier. Now we're ready to attach our first microbit, the wind force sensor. Let's attach it near the axis and close to the edge of the board to let the flap swing freely. Attach the battery pack to the popsicle stick closest to the microbit and secure it with masking tape. We aren't quite finished, but we can already use this device to measure wind strength or how big your lung capacity is. Try blowing the flap to see how long you can keep it moving. What if you wanted to use your weather station to measure water levels? Let's add a special accessory that will let us do this. Slowly push the shorter dowel into the styrofoam ball. Glue the other end of the dowel to the last large popsicle stick. Finally, attach the end of the popsicle stick to the middle of the flap with a bit of masking tape. Your accessory is ready to use. You can use the station with or without the water measure. Now it's time to start collecting some data. Test your Microbit weather station by raising and lowering the flap. On the makeup page of your second Microbit, you should see a button on the left below the simulator called Show Console Device. Click it to see your Microbit collect data in real time. Why don't you track how your environment changes over time? You can use the download icon on the console page to download your data in a CSV file. You nailed it! You're now the happy owner of a Microbit weather station. But why stop there? Are you ready to level up? Imagine there's a flood coming. Can you create an alarm that goes off when the water gets too high? How about an alarm that goes off when the water gets too low in a river? How about detecting wind direction? Here's a hint. Try the compass feature. Could you use your Microbit weather station as a smart cat flap to count how many times your cat goes outside or comes back in? Like this video and subscribe to our channel for more coding tips and tricks. See you soon!